ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओम शांति शांति शांति। वर्ष नंबर 384 विशुद्ध मन्ता करणम स्वरूपे निवेश्य साक्षिण्य अवबोध मात्रे शनै शनैर निश्चलता मुपानयन पूर्णम स्वयमेवा अनुविलोपये ततः। आई चांट अगेन। विशुद्ध मन्ता करणम स्वरूपे निवेशय साक्षिण अवबोध मात्रे शनै शनै निश्चलता मुपानयन पूर्णम स्वयमेवा अनुविलोपये ततः। The translation is, by fixing the purified inner organ upon the self, which is the witness and knowledge absolute, and gradually making it quiet, one should behold the state of fullness of one's own self. See the translation again one more time. Fixing the purified mind in the self, which is witness, the knowledge absolute, and slowly making it still, one must then realize one's own infinite self. New topic, but thought is same. Continuous it is continuously keep watching your real nature. In previous chapter, having understood the method of meditation, then method of sampragyat samadhi and asampragyat samadhi. Now the seeker has reached the point of the self-realization. Shankaracharya says, Visuddha Manta Karanam. For self-realization, the one thing is must for everyone, the thing is the purity of the inner instrument, purity of the mind. For everyone, every seeker, without any exception, this condition is for everyone, the mind should be pure. By the path of meditation, the samadhi, the seeker realizes his own pure nature. Pure nature means without any condition. without any mixing, just as it is. As long as our knowledge is rooted in other than you. It may be rooted in scriptures, it may be rooted in Guru. It is not rooted in you. In this state, as long as you are connected to the scriptures or to the Guru, your knowledge remains fresh, strong, bright. When connection breaks with Guru, with the scriptures, our knowledge of the self becomes faded. That is why sometimes when we read the scriptures, it seems, yes, I got it. It is very clear. But after study, all things becomes same as they were before. In Asampragya Samadhi state, the self-knowledge takes place in you. In Asampragya Samadhi, its roots start to take ground in you. Now, the realization of the self, it is started sprouting in you. Shankaracharya says, this is the very beginning. As you plant its seed, and when it just started, just a shape of sprout becomes very careful. We take more care because it is very small, very fragile. Anything can break it. In Asampragya Samadhi, when a sadhak entered, the seeker gets taste of pure self. But this state happens for very little moment. Just a thought for very little moments. Shankaracharya says, Vishuddha Manta Karanam Sarupe Vinivesya Shakshini Abhibodhamatra. Then the sadhak should keep practicing always. The sadhak should always keep pondering. He should always think about oneness. Shankaracharya in this verse advising a way of thinking. He says, if mind is pure, it will think about Atman. Impure mind cannot enter into Atman. The Atman is witnessed by nature. It cannot be witnessed. It can be experienced when all mediums of knowledge becomes meaningless. When last medium of the knowledge, mind, merges with unborn knowledge. Shanai sanai nishchalatam upeti. In beginning, the state of this understanding may appear for very little time, and after you may forget. So more practice is needed to make mind stable there. When we study a books, when we go listen to a master, then for some time the reality becomes clear and we forget. Shankaracharya says, keep doing your practice. Gradually by practice, it will become still. The seeker can extend the duration of this realization. Suppose in very beginning, this state happens only for 1 minute. But by practice, it can be extended for 2 minutes, then 3 minutes, then 4 minutes. Sanai sanai nischalatam upaniya. So this time is not for overnight. It will take time. It requires your patience. Purnam sameva avalokayet. He says, in that state, the seeker should try to understand Purnam, the complete, the oneness. Everywhere, same one consciousness is everywhere. Purnam samev an avilokayet tatha. So here Shankaracharya advising directly to seeker, avalokayet. Think again and again, again and again. You are the poor. You are the complete. Now next one. Dehendriya prana manu ahamadibhi swagyan kirtai rakhilai rupadibhi vimuktamatmanam akhanda rupam purnam mahakasmiva avalokayet. I repeat again. Dehendriya prana manu ahamadibhi swagyan kirtai rakhilai rupadibhi vimuktatmanam akhanda rupam purnam mahakasmiva avalokayet. The meaning is, free from all limitations like the body, sense organs, pranas, mind and ego, which are projections of one's ignorance, let one come to realize the self, the indivisible and infinite, like the great all-pervading space. In this verse, Shankaracharya ji is explaining and advising to the seeker that we know ourselves always. Always, everywhere. One thing is doubtless, one knowledge doubtless, that I am. I am. Everything can be forgotten. We can forget house, we can forget property, we can forget family, country. In coma state, we can forget everything. What my name is, we can forget. Relatives, property, bank balance, anything can be forgotten. What in any condition, any situation, one thing is always with you, that is I am. The knowledge of yourself, it cannot be forgotten. The knowledge of the self is always with you. I am. Doubtless, anything is doubtful. Any condition is doubtful. Even God is also doubtful. You may believe, you may not. Someone believes, some not. But one thing is doubtless, that is I am, my presence. My presence is doubtless, absolute. But the knowledge of the self is not pure self. It is with condition. We see ourselves, we know ourselves, but limited, conditioned. And these conditions, which are projection of our ignorance. So, I am, my presence is always everywhere. Without this knowledge, any knowledge cannot take place. Anything cannot take place. First thing is, I am. I am is what? I, consciousness. So without this knowledge, without this understanding, anything, even God, even heaven, scripture, guru, master, anything cannot happen. Always is. The only problem is, actually we have an idea that we exist, no doubt. No doubt, I am. My existence is absolute. The only this knowledge is, it is not doubtable. So your presence is absolute, doubtless. It does not require any support. But here is one thing. I am, this is the Sat. The word is Satchidananda. Sat Chit Anand. So Sat is very, very clear. I am. So Sat is very clear. But in next level, Chit and Anand, you need sadhana. So we know myself, I self. I know myself, you know yourself, they know themselves, but we do not know ourselves pure. We mix something. We do not know ourselves completely. So our completeness is important. In Gita, Lord Sri Krishna says to Arjun and Sri Krishna, but they were like a friend, they were like a discipling master, they were like God and devotee. In the 18th chapter, Lord Sri Krishna says, Bhaktya mam abhijanati yavan yashasmi tattata tato mam tattato gyatva visate tadanantam. See the meaning. Lord Sri Krishna says, through devotion, he come to know me fully. The world is fully. Who and what I am in reality. Who I am and how I am. Knowing me thus in truth, he forthwith enters into me. We know God. Everyone knows God. Some believe, some doesn't. But everyone knows God. But the devotee not just knows God, he experienced God. He can experience God. So there are two persons. One who has knowledge of the God. God is omnipresent, omniscient, just information. But one is devotee who knows, who experiences God is everywhere. Such devotee, Krishna says, such devotee can enter into me because he knows me, who am I? He knows me, my glory. He respects me. Same. This is the perspective of the devotion. Now we are thinking the perspective of the Vedanta. Same I, aham, my I, self. So everyone knows about self. Animals also knows, birds knows, creature knows, everyone knows. But our knowing, our understanding is partially. We do not know our glory, our splendor, our glory are covered by our own ignorance. We do not know our full existence. We know ourselves partially. Why? Because the expression of the consciousness, happens through the body, through the mind, through the prana, like electricity. Electricity can be experienced through the devices. A switch on and light, you can see there is light. A switch on, AC start working. It means light is there, electricity is there. But without devices, if there is no any device, even though electricity is there, electricity does not need device. It exists. Same. Soul, the consciousness, can remain without devices. So body, prana, mind, these all are the devices. Through them, the self expresses itself. Shankaracharya says, Dehendriya Prana Mano Amadidhi. So we know ourselves, but our understanding is partial. These we can say upadhi. And the upadhis are projected by us. In this body, I am limited. In a particular body, in particular mind, particular sense organs, harmai, pranas, these all are our boundaries. We feel that we are limited. I am in this body. I think I am in this body. I am not anywhere. I am in this time. I was not past. I will not be in future. I am here right now. This place is limitation for me. I am here. It means I am nowhere. So time, space, the body, mind. There are so many upadhis, so many conditions. Shankaracharya says, Dehendriya Prana Manu Amadidhi Shogyana Kilittai Rakhilai Upadidhi. Your duty is just renounce all these. Just renounce all these. I am not the body. Vice versa, body is in me. I am not the prana. Pranas are in me. Every body is in me. In asampragyat savadi, this thought can be known. In this state, this thought seems no practical. How is it possible? I am everywhere. Yes, Shankaracharya says, Vimukta Atmanam Akhanda Rupa. You free, you make free yourself. You make free yourself from the body, from the mind, from these boundaries, then you will come to know that you are the Purnam, complete, everywhere, like the sky. Now, next one. Ghata kalas, ghata kalas, usula sucha mukhyai, gagana mupadhi satai vimukti mekam, bhavati na vividam tathai vasuttam, param ahamadi vimukti mekam eva. I repeat again. Ghata kalas, usula sucha mukhyai, gagana mupadhi satai vimukti mekam, Bhavatina dividham tathaiva suddham param ahamadi vimukta mekameva. See the translation. Having dropped hundreds of its limitations, such as a boat, a pitcher, a barn, or the eye of the needle, space is recognized as one and not as many. So too, the pure supreme Brahman is indeed one when freed from the ego and the rest. In previous verse, he gave an example, Mahakasam Miva. So now he is explaining how Mahakas means iska. So first, we have to think about Mahakas. The sky is one. There is no division. There is no parts. Everywhere one sky is. It cannot divide it into pieces. That is why the example of the sky very useful to understand the consciousness. In Vedanta, many times this example can be used because very similar. The space is one. This is not my space, your space. Space is one everywhere. But because of upadhi, because of condition, it could appear many. It could appear pieces. And even we know sky is one, but it appears many. How? Shankaracharya here gives some names. Ghat. Ghat means a pot. Kalas also the pot. Kusul. Kusul means like a godown, storehouse. Suchi Mukhei, the eye of the needle. In Vedanta, many times we used to say Ghatakas. Ghatakas, Mathakas, Patakas. Now I will explain. Akas is one, sky is one. But we have so many ports. Suppose you have 100 ports. Big size, small size, it is not matter. Every port has its own boundary. Or because of that boundary, every pot has its own space. Like you are sitting in your house. There may be 2, 3, 4 rooms. Every room has its own space. Personal space. So this room's space, another room's space are not same. This room's space, another. That room's space is another. Here Shankaracharya given ghat, a pot. Every pot has its own space. Because of that boundary, we think in this space, in this pot, there is separate space. In that pot, there is a separate space. In another pot, there is a separate space. In this room, there is a different space. Another room, there is another space. So many pieces we do in sky. But if you break them, then what happens? If you break the pot, then what happens? The sky which was inside, nothing. Before some time there was no pot. After some time the pot will not no more. Very few time this port has come. So Shankaracharya says, everywhere, same sky is everywhere. But because of the condition, we see that they behave like there are many, many spaces. We behave like there are many, many spaces. Same. Vimukti meka. If you can free from all boundaries, the space is one. Same here. He is advising to seekers. In the state of asamprajnat samadhi, the seeker encounters self without any upadhi. Upadhi means conditions. When we superimpose the self with the body, with the mind, with the sense organs, with the ego, it becomes many. My body, in this body, my soul. Their bodies, their soul. So everybody, it looks like everybody has its own private soul. See, only Vedanta can say oneness. Vedanta can experience oneness. No other can experience the oneness. We think in this body is separate soul. Another body is a separate soul. Another body has its own soul. Vedanta says, no. Just remove all upadis, conditions. Tathaiva suddham param ahamadi vimukte vekam meva. If you renounce, eliminate all upadis, I am not the body. Body is there. Mind is there. But I am not mind. Devices are there. There is a bulb, there is a pen, there is a computer, there is a AC, but electricity does not it. Electricity is very different from the devices. So body is device, mind is device, sense organs are device, but you are not. You are just a power, just electricity. And electricity, the power is one. He says, ekam meva. This is the thought of oneness. Oneness. I am one everywhere. So because of upadhi, because of condition like sky appears many, same, because of condition of the body, mind, sense organs, the one self, one consciousness appears many. In fact, it is one. Now, next one. Very important verse. Brahmadistambha pariyanta mrisha matra upadhaya tata purnam samatmanam pasyet ekam atmanasthitam. I repeat again. Brahmadistambha pariyanta mrisha matra upadhaya tata purnam samatmanam pasyet ekam atmanasthitam. See the translation. Right from Brahma down to a blade of grass, all conditioning adjuncts are quite unreal. Therefore, one should realize oneself as one and only existent principle. See the translation. The upadhi from Brahma down to the blade of the grass are all simply unreal. Therefore, One should realize one's own infinite self as ever identified with his being. See, the dedication of the Vedanta to the truth. Only Vedanta can declare such a statement. No other philosophy can dare. Vedanta can reveal such form of the pure form of the reality. He says, down from the Brahma. See, all creation is upadhi. Creation means the universe. All creation is upadhi. Upadhi means condition. Some conditions are for me, some conditions may be for you, some conditions some other. But all creation is a condition. Limitation. Limitation for whom? Limitation for self. So all conditions are, all universe is a condition. Body. So in our scriptures says the earth is also a body. Dharti ma. The divine form of the earth is like a goddess. So earth is like, earth is not just inert, it is a body. Water is also body. Its self is Varuna Devata. Same fire, air, space. These all are the bodies. Conditions. For me, my body is my condition. For you, your body is your condition. For divine goddess of the earth, the dharti is a condition. What is the condition? So all creation is a condition for self. And not Shankaracharya stops here. He says, the entire universe is a condition. Even more, not only the world is a condition, even the divine world also a condition. Upadhi, divine world, heaven, the hell, other lokas, they all are the condition. You two have been heaven. I think you two must have been heaven. You may have been in King of Devatas. So there are many gods, many lokas. They all are set up. Shankaracharya says, they are also conditioned. They are not pure soul. That is why Devata also trying to know self. In Upanishads, there is a story. Once Devaraj Indra and Virochan went to Brahmaji to know self. Because they have subtle body, they have divine body, but still body is body, body is a condition. Not even gods, body. He says Brahma's body. Brahma means what? Brahma means all divine manifestation of any form. Brahma does not mean only Brahma. Brahma means the starting point from body has started. So we can say because Brahma is the creator. Before creator there was no anybody. So Brahma is the first body. Shankaracharya says Brahma Stambha Paryanta, beginning from the Brahma, the very pure, powerful, long life, more durable body of Brahmas. So Brahma does not mean only Brahma. Brahma means any divine form. You can call it Vishnu, Shiva, Indra, Varuna, any incarnation of the God. They all are upadhis. They are body. Their body is actually, their body is also not permanent because body is conditioned. So Brahma, any other gods, that is why they take body and they leave the body. The god takes avatar for some time and then went. Their lokas, their reality. Lokas means their reality. So Brahma is the creator of the universe. So Brahma is also upadhi. So from right the Brahma down to the atom, or whatever you may think, the minutest of the universe, is all are upadhi. Brahma, Shankaracharya says, Brahmadi stambha paryanta mrisha matra upadhaya. These all are, the mrisha means appearance. Just they appear, they have no any reality. Only Vedanta can teach such great teachings. No doubt, quality of the body is different. The power, understanding, expression of the soul, durability is very different. But Shankaracharya says, it makes no difference. Condition body is body. It makes no difference. Brahma's body is also body, and minutest unit of the universe, this body is also body. See the theory. Conditions are conditions. Creation and creator, both are the upadhi. Tata Purnam Samatmanam Paseda Ekam Atmanastitam. Shankaracharya says, if you realize yourself without condition, it will be very different. Now we know myself. You know yourself. But our understanding is, this is the my height, this is the my weight, this is the my caste, this is the my form, this is the my property. So this understanding is because of condition. If you would know yourself without condition, you will come to know you are heightless, you are weightless, you are limitless. You are always same. You are without modification. You are without changes. Ekam Atmanaha. Now next one. Yatra Bhrantya Kalpitam Tad Viveke तत्तन्मात्रम नैव तस्मात् विभिन्नम् भ्रांतेर नाशे भाति दृष्टा ही इतत्वम् रज्जुस्तद्वद् विश्वमात्म स्वरूपम्। आई रिपीट अगेन, यत्र भ्रांत्या कल्पितम् तद्विवेके तत्तन्मात्रम नैव तस्मात् विभिन्नम् भ्रांतेर नाशे भाति दृष्टा ही तत्वम् रज्जुस्तद्वद् विश्वमात्म स्वरूपम्। See the translation very carefully. Where we mistake something is imagined to exist, there no right discrimination. The real itself is recognized, there being nothing other than it. With the error removed, the falsely perceived snake vanishes and the rope appears. As the truth, so to the entire universe is in truth only the self. In this verse, Shankaracharya is giving one principle and one example and one message. Three things have been said in this verse. One is a principle, another is an example, and third one is a message. He wanted to give the seekers. So that is why in this verse, three things. Yatra bhrantya kalpitam tat viveke. The imagined object has no own existence apart from its substratum. I repeat again. The imagined object has no its existence apart from its substratum. Because of delusion, we mistake something, we misjudge something, we cannot judge properly. And imagination happens. Imagination means when our knowing object does not exist in a reality, but it is in our mind. It may be somewhere, but right now and here it does not exist. But in mind it exists. Mind is feeling. Take an example to understand this. Very famous and classical example of Vedanta is snake and rope. Snake and rope. When we misjudge a rope, it appears like snake. And its consequence, we start shivering, afraid. There are so many effects because of the imaginary snake. There is no snake, but this imaginary snake is in our mind. Snake is a reality in other place, but here in this place there is no snake. Rantir nasam drishtahitattvam rajju. There is a rope. So substratum is rope. Snake is a imaginary object. So what should one do? What should one do? only thing is you know the substratum. Shankaracharya says, tat viveke. Go and understand, discriminate. What is this? Is it snake or not? Tat viveke. You go and try to understand. Don't accept. This is the way of Vedanta. Vedanta says you try to understand. And when you will come to know, this is the rope. This is the rope. Then he asking a question. If you have known this the rope, what about your imaginary snake? What happens? Where he has gone? You will say, there was no snake. So there is no meaning thinking about the snake. Snake was just imaginary. The rope is reality. Shankaracharya says, same. Tatvat Vishwam Atma Sarupam. The world is appear. In very beginning, you were told, you renunciate the world, renunciate this one. But after this understanding, world is nothing. No world, no snake, just imaginary. Vedanta says, go and know what is reality. If you would know the reality, the world will disappear. And only consciousness is there. If you would know, then only consciousness is there. World will disappear. World is imaginary. The reality is you. Atma Sarupa. Then there is no two. You and the world, snake and the rope, there are not two. One thing. Snake and rope, there are not two. There is only one. Same consciousness in the world, there are not two, just one. The only thing is, you have to know. You have to know substratum. The illusion will disappear, the world will disappear, and consciousness is everywhere. Nothing else. So he says, Tatvat Vishwam Atma Sarupam. This all universe, nothing other than consciousness. The world is not apart from the consciousness. The world is a consciousness. There is not two. There is just one. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Kritau Vande Bhagavantau Puna Punaha Isharu Guru Ratmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.